Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Pada hari ini saya ingin kongsikan bagaimana untuk simulate satu flowsheet yang lengkap yang terdiri daripada reaktor, kemudian separation proses, dan kemudian ada open loop and closed loop. So open loop maknanya ada tiada recycle, closed loop ada recycle. Jadi contoh yang kita akan lihat pada sesi video ini ialah cyclohexane production. Okay, objektif dalam sesi ini lah untuk construct and Aspen Plus flowsheet simulation of the production of cyclohexane via benzene hydrogenation. Second, become familiar with user interface and tools associated with Aspen Plus. So basically this is the problem or the process description. So the problem is to construct an Aspen Plus simulation to model the production of cyclohexane via benzene hydrogenation. The simplified flowsheet for this process is shown in the next slide. Okay, so basically, fresh benzene and hydrogen feed streams are first fed through a heater to bring the streams up to reactor feed temperature and pressure conditions. Okay, and this feed mixture is then sent to a fixed bed catalytic reactor. Okay, fixed bed catalytic reactor where three hydrogen molecules react with one benzene molecule to form cyclohexane. Okay, the simulation will use a Ørsted reactor block. Okay, to model this reaction. So we have looked at the Ørsted reactor block ni from previous lecture. So basically, Ørsted block is a simple reactor model which requires a user specific reaction with a specified limiting component as well as extent of reaction. The reactor effluent stream is then sent to a flash tank to separate the light and heavy components of the mixture. The vapor stream coming off the flash tank is recycled back to the feed mixture after a small purge stream is removed to prevent impurities from building up in the stream. So dalam case ni ada recycle back. When recycle back, it is a closed loop. And then a small purge, okay, is removed, okay, from the effluent from the vapor stream of the flash tank, basically to prevent impurities from building up in the system. The majority of the liquid stream leaving the flash tank goes to a distillation column to purify the cyclohexane product, while a small portion of the liquid stream is recycled back to the feed mixture to minimize losses of benzene. Okay. And then process operating specification are listed in the following page or in the following slide. Okay, we look here the flow sheet of the process. So we have feed here, hydrogen feed, benzene feed. So it is heated up before fed to the reactor. So this is a Ørsted reactor lah. Ørsted reactor. And then we have flash here. Okay, the vapor from the flash, so part of it will be recycled back, okay, and part of it will be purged out of the system to prevent accumulation inside the whole system. And then the liquid from the flash, some of it will be recycled back, okay, to the reactor, and the other portion will go to decision column. So we buy the separated to produce the cyclohexane as a product. Okay, next is the process specification. So here we have the information for the feed stream, right? This is benzene feed. Okay. So the whole section here is the feed stream information. Okay. So the benzene stream as well as the hydrogen feed stream. And then we have the preheater information. Okay, preheater information as well as the reactor information. So given here is the stoichiometric as well as the conversion, also the temperature and pressure drop, so this is a pressure drop, and then information of the flash tank given at the bottom here is the distillation condition. Okay. And then we have also information on the push stream as well as the liquid stream, liquid split. Sorry. So that is basically the process specification. Next we will go to Aspen Plus to simulate this particular process. So I have opened here Aspen Plus. So when you create a new file, first thing that you need to do is to specify the components involved in the process. It will include the reactant as well as product and also any other component involved in the process. So basically if you look at the process specification here, it tells us what are the component involved. Basically in the benzene feed we have benzene. Okay, so this is a pure component here. Whereas for hydrogen feed, we have hydrogen 97.5, okay, and then nitrogen 0.5, as well as methane. So this is basically the feed component. For the product, we have cyclohexane. Okay, so this is our product lah. Jadi dalam komponen kita, overall kita ada hidrogen, nitrogen, methane, benzin dan juga cyclohexane. Ada 5 komponen dalam proses ni. Jadi kita specify komponen-komponen tadi. First is hydrogen. Kedua nitrogen. Ketiga methane. Keempat benzin. Dan ketiga cyclohexane. Okay, jika komponen tak ada sini, kita tekan find and then kita type nama penuh ni, cyclohexane, klik find now. Kita tengok keluar tak dalam list of komponen ni. Okay, cyclohexane. Kita klik add selected compound and then kita klik close. Okay, sini cyclohexane. So ini ialah komponen yang terlibat. Kemudian next step kita boleh klik sama ada next ni ataupun method. Okay, kita klik next And then base method, kita pilih rk-solver. Okay, kat sini ada. Alright. And then we click next. So yang ni jadual ni menunjukkan binary interaction value yang ada dalam database Aspen. Okay. Jadi dia nak tunjukkanlah bahawa binary interaction data tu ada. So kita klik next terus to run di property analysis. Okay, so table generation completed dan dekat bawah ni ada results available. Yeah. And then next kita boleh terus pergi ke simulation untuk kita draw flowsheet kita lah. Okay. Okay, inilah flowsheet untuk cyclohexane production via benzene hydrogenation. Ada satu preheater, satu reactor, satu flash dan satu distillation column. So dalam nota dia akan tunjukkan cara ataupun step by step untuk draw the flowsheet. And at the end dia akan simulate lah. So saya nak tunjukkan macam mana kalau nak buat satu per satu. So kita try to solve one by one, preheater and then reactor, kemudian flash, kemudian distillation column lah. Kita akan cuba buat satu per satu. Okay, kita mulakan dengan kita definekan unit yang pertama, which is kita punya preheat lah. So pertama kita di model palette klik Essential tab and then kita klik preheat. Okay, jadi kita boleh namakan, oh sorry, dah satu kita delete. Alright, so kita namakan dia sebagai preheat. Kemudian kita attachkan kita punya material stream. Ada dua material stream. Pertama ialah H2 feed dan yang kedua ialah benzene feed lah. Kita renamekan dia, kita jadikan H2 feed dan yang bawah ni ialah benzene feed. The output stream from the heater will go to the reactor. Okay, so ni dipanggil, kita namakan sebagai reactor in. Okay, kita tak sambung lagi kepada reactor. Kita cuba untuk softkan ataupun simulate preheat ni. First thing yang kita kena define ialah information, the feed information. So dalam ni kita define untuk kita punya feed dulu, ini H2 feed. Ni H2 feed. Okay, temperature 120 Fahrenheit. Pressure 35 PSIA. And then total flow basis is mole, total flow rate 310. Daripada sini pound mole per hour. And then mole fraction, okay, hydrogen value 0.975, nitrogen 0.005 dan methane 0.02. Okay, ni information untuk benzene. Kemudian kita tengok information on dari hydrogen, sorry, kita pergi kepada benzene pula. Benzene feed Temperature dia 100 Fahrenheit. Pressure is 15 PSIA. Total flow basis mole, total flow rate 100 pound mole per hour eh. Kemudian kat sini ialah mole fraction, which is benzene is in pure condition lah. Okay, so kita dah selesai set up feed stream information. Next, kita pergi kepada preheat kita. So, dalam problem description tadi, kita nak preheat dia. Preheat dia to 300 Fahrenheit, 330 PSIA eh. So temperature is 300 Fahrenheit, pressure is 330 PSIA eh. Alright, so basically kita dah boleh run dah ni. Okay, kita klik next dulu untuk dapatkan notification which all the input is complete. Okay, and now we can run the simulation eh. Click okay. Okay, so no errors, no warning, so we can proceed to the next unit operation eh, which is kita punya reactor. Okay, this part lah reactor. So kita pergi pada model palette, klik reactor step. Dalam ni kita pilih Arstoid eh. Okay, Arstoid. Then kita sambungkan stream ni. Right click, reconnect, and kita klik reconnect destination. So we click to the feed port, and then we need to attach the output stream eh. And then this one we rename it as R up. Rename the reactor as REAC eh, reactor. Okay, so we specify the reactor information. So before we do that, we need to specify the reaction eh. Okay, pergi pada reaction tab, and then click new. Okay, reaction ID is okay, untuk Arstoid kita tak perlu untuk specify reaction ID ni. Dia boleh terus buat dekat reactor block tadi eh. So kita cancel, kita pergi pada reactor. Okay, kita identify dulu dia punya condition. Kita lihat balik yang ni, sorry, specification. So reactor eh, so this is reactor, benzene. Okay, stoichiometry dia, conversion dia, outlet temperature 400 Fahrenheit, and pressure drop 15 PSI eh. Okay, temperature tadi 400 Fahrenheit, and then pressure is pressure drop eh, is negative 15. Ni kena lihat betul-betul, kena ada tulis pressure drop, it is negative 15 eh, PSI eh. Kita tulis sini lah pressure drop PSI. Okay, next kita specify reaction ya. Klik new. Okay, so kita ada reactant kita ialah benzene dan juga hydrogen. Kita letakkan symmetric coefficient dia, benzene 1, hydrogen 3. And then produk ni lah cyclohexane, sanggometri lah satu eh. And then diberikan tadi dia punya conversion 99.8%, so it will be 0.998 of component benzene eh. Alright. Next, so basically kita dah pun siap bahagian reaktor ni dan kita boleh run eh. Okay, check control panel, no errors or warning were issued. Basically, kita boleh tengok result di reaktor ni. Kita pergi ke results, sorry, streams result eh. Kita tengok mol flow rate dia. Right. So, hidrogen pun dah berkurang. Benzin pun berkurang. Dan bertambahnya nilai ataupun mol flow for cyclohexane eh. Ini result dia. Okay, the next step. Sorry, kita ada flash column kita. Okay, this is our flash column. So, dalam flow sheet ni kita sambungkan dia dengan flash column. So, go to separator. Okay, flash eh. Okay, separator step. Click flash. So, dia ada two type of flash kat sini. Yang flash yang pertama ni ialah untuk two outlet flash eh. Kalau yang ni dia ada three outlet flash. So, dia involve vapor liquid-liquid lah. Okay, so the liquid will have two phase of liquid. Okay, kita attachkan R out dengan flash ni tadi. And then kita ada vapor stream and also the liquid stream eh. Atau dinamakan dia sebagai vap 1. Yang ni kita namakan sebagai liquid 1 eh. Okay, yang ni kita namakan sebagai flash lah. Okay. Okay, selesai itu kita spesifikan flash information. So, dalam ni kita lihat flash dia, temperature 120, pressure drop eh, 5 PSI. So, temperature is 120 Fahrenheit. And we have pressure drop eh. So, pressure drop tadi ingat, negatif 5 eh. So, this is PSI lah. Okay, so dah specify kat sini dan kita boleh run terus ataupun klik next eh. Okay, no errors or warning were issued. Jadi kalau ada error lah katakan, jadi kita tahu yang error tu datang daripada bahagian flash ni. Sebab sebelum ni kita dah pastikan bahawa tiada warning or error pada reactor block dan juga pada preheat block ni. Jadi kita boleh fokus troubleshooting itu pada flash block ini saja. Ini kelebihan lah kalau kita buat satu per satu eh. Okay, next next kita ada satu vapor split ke atas ni. Part of it will go back to the preheat dan dia ada satu lagi lah push strip eh. So pergi kepada mixer splitter tab. Okay, ni ada mixer ni split eh. So kita pilih split lah. Okay, kita boleh kecilkan sikit ni size dia. Okay. And then kita boleh juga rotate dia eh. Rotate to the left lah. Okay. Sambungkan vapor line ni ke splitter. So ada dua output eh daripada sini. Satu to one stream. Okay, dia akan pergi kepada preheat dan satu lagi dia pergi ke purge line lah. Okay, kita namakan dulu yang ni purge, P-U-R-G-E, dan inilah vapor recycle eh. Alright, So ini kita namakan sebagai split one. Split one eh. So split one ni kita kena specifikan ratio dia. Untuk per stream, okay, per rate is 8% of vapor recycle stream. Okay, 8% eh. So kita klik kat sini. And then kita buat kat purge, value-nya ialah 0.08, okay, ataupun 8% lah. Okay. So dah specify, dah biru, and then kita boleh run this particular unit eh. Okay, as overload. And then we do the same for the liquid stream. So kita ada splitter lagi. Okay, kita rotatekan dia. And then we attach the liquid stream to the mixer. And then ada dua outlet di sini. Okay, one is feed to the session column, and the other one will be liquid recycle stream. Eh, kita namakan ni sebagai split two. Okay, and then we look at the problem. It says here 70% of liquid stream goes to the distillation column. Okay. Okay, C-feed, sorry, liquid, 0.3 upon 30% will be recycled back lah. Okay, so the other 70% will go to the distillation column. So then we can run this. The simple operation, so shouldn't pose any problem lah. Okay. Okay, at this stage sebenarnya kita dah siap hampir maybe 90% lah, except ada satu distillation column di sini. So basically for this open loop untuk this three particular unit operation, kita dah berjaya selesaikan. Okay, this is a open loop eh, open loop with no recycle stream connected back. Okay, to the process. So kat sini kita boleh tengok result dia. Okay, boleh tengok result, take home, pergi ke home dan stream summary. You can look at all the result for each stream. Okay, so next ialah kita nak sambungkan this recycle stream. The vapor will be recycled to the preheater as well as the liquid recycle back to the preheater eh. So basically kalau kita tak sambung ni, dipanggil test stream lah, kita koyakkan dia. Kalau recycle, kita sambungkan dia semula. Okay, so at this stage actually kita dah boleh run. Kita tengok result dia. So you can do at home to find out the difference between before recycle and after recycle. You will see the difference lah in the molar flow rate and so on. Okay, next we'll attach the C feed to a distillation column. Okay, at the tab model palette here, we select column step, and then we select this one, we select refract refract. So kita ada, this is a feed stream. Okay, and then we have kat sini dia letakkan sebagai vapor distillate and then this is the bottom stream lah. Okay, this is your C feed. This is column, and then distillate, and then this is the bottom strip. So given here is the information of the distillation column, number of stages 15, feed stage 8, default ratio 1.2, circular action recovery 99.9 in bottoms. This one nanti kita boleh gunakan design spec untuk dapatkan this recovery value, and then condenser pressure is 200 PSI. Okay, we click on the red fret block. So number of stages is 15. Condenser is partial vapor, partial vapor. And then we look at the bottom rate here. Is in mole 45. Ni at the current moment ni kita boleh apa orang kata dapatkan initial value dulu. Reflux ni dibagi kan. So basically bottom rate ni, okay, untuk bottom product is basically kita punya cyclohexane. Jadi kita kena somehow estimate lah bottom rate ni, dan kalau boleh kita nak sebanyak mungkin cyclohexane di bawah. Untuk dapatkan initial estimation, kita boleh pergi pada feed dan tengok pada mole flow dia. Okay, kita tengok cyclohexane sini 45.2 kan. So we can use this as a basis lah. So maknanya kalau 99.9 purity tu mungkin dalam 45, okay, bottom rate tu. Jadi kita boleh pergi pada column, kita letakkan as an initial 45.23. So you boleh gunakan this one as initial estimation lah untuk bottom rate ni, sebab kita tahu kat bottom ni saya koleksin. Next, kita pergi pada stream. So feed stage kita pada stage yang ke-8, and then pressure given dalam problem tadi ialah 200 PSI. Okay, PSI. So at this stage sebenarnya kita dah boleh run dia. Okay, kita klik next. So all the input is complete, so you can run the simulation. Okay, no errors and warning available. So kita boleh tengok lah result untuk column ni. Simulation pane, kita pergi pada stream results. Okay, so we have bottom and distillate. So bottom kita punya product, we look at the mole fraction macam mana. 99.86 dia punya purity at the bottom. So dalam problem, apa yang kita nak ialah recovery dia 99.99. Kita nak recovery dia 99.99. Manually kita boleh kira lah yang ni. To get the exact recovery result, so kita pergi, kita kena buat column ni design spec. Okay, design spec. So design spec, kita pergi pada bahagian specification here. Okay, design spec. Okay, design spec. Kita klik new. So kita letak recovery lah. Okay, recovery. Okay, type kita lah mole recovery. Target kita tadi 99.99%. So we put sorry 9999. Okay, so we need to specify the component. Komponen apa yang kita nak, which is cyclohexane. Okay, so kita provide the stream information. Stream apa? Which is the bottom stream lah. Okay, bottom stream. This is the feed stream. Right. So next step yang kita buatlah, kita specifikan variable apa yang kita nak vary. Okay, so dalam ni kita boleh vary refresh ratio pun boleh. So antara dua tadi yang kita specify di bahagian sini eh. So operating specification ni ada dua je, refresh ratio dengan bottom rate. Jadi vary ni dia kena salah satu daripada dua variable ni. So kita pilih bottom rate. Kita letakkan range between 40 to 50 lah. Okay. So range ni kita tengok balik dekat fit tadi ni. Okay, fit tadi. So input dia 45. So make sure that within this range eh. Okay, so dah specify, kita tengok, click next. Okay, run simulation now. Okay, kita run eh. So, no warning, so error were issued. Okay, and then kita boleh check result kita. Result, stream results. Okay, mole fraction. Okay, kalau you buat manual calculation, you will get lah. Recovery 99.9. Actually kita boleh tengok juga dekat vary ni tadi. Sorry, design spec ni tengok result eh. So ni result ni 99.99%. So calculated value is 99.99%. Eh. Okay, kita pergi ke vary untuk lihatkan final value dia berapa. Final value dia ialah 45.29 eh. 45.29. Basically apa yang you boleh buat lepas ni, you boleh reconcilekan result ni. Okay, so basically apa dia buat, dia letakkan this value lah, value tadi dalam input untuk configuration ni eh. So kita boleh run balik lah semula. Okay, kita boleh tengok result dia. This is the column result, the stream results. Okay, untuk the selection column, the overall result, kita boleh pergi pada home untuk klik pada stream summary eh. So ni the overall stream result for this particular process. Okay, dalam nota dia ada optional exercise, so saya nak you can try it. Okay, dalam nota nanti saya akan attachkan nota ni lah dalam kalam eh. So selamat mencuba, jika ada masalah boleh maklumkan pada saya. So thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.